I'm so happy for them. I don't know what that...
Welcome to Intellectual Froglegs with special guest, Town Hall columnist John Hawkins. And now, the host of Intellectual Froglegs, the guy stood in line for 3 hours just to get his own autograph, Joe Dan Gorman.
Is it rude to throw a breath mint in somebody's mouth while they're talking? Welcome to Intellectual Froglegs. We're back. You know, we might be bruised and beaten and limping, but we'll never walk funny. In just a little bit, we have a visit from Town Hall columnist and my friend, John Hawkins.
John Hawkins.
Guess what? It's football season. Thank goodness. I get sick of baseball. You know, it seems like it's ever going to end. They have like 417 regular season games now or something. But anyway, back to football. Jacksonville, your Jaguars need to be begging Tim Tebow to come over and help you. And for you Tebow haters, you cannot point to one team where Tim Tebow has been the starter that was not a winner. And I hated missing the big NFC East battle on Sunday night between the Cowboys and the Giants. But you know what? I didn't hate it enough to support NBC by watching it. A friend of mine on Facebook, David Ryden, pointed out that generally, whatever game you're interested in, you go to NFL.com, click on the team page, and listen to the radio broadcast for free. And then some of you guys that just can't miss your team, I can't miss my Jets, I can't miss my Packers, I can't miss my Cowboys. Go to a sports bar. They've already bought the NFL package anyway. You're not going to help anybody. Just keep your TVs and your computers and your other devices commie-free. And now, here's a surprise. Jeb Bush is giving an award to Hillary Clinton. That's fitting, though. Really, seriously. I bet it's not a box of cigars. But no joke, many in the media think this is going to be your presidential candidate in 2016. Now, that's a terrifying thought, isn't it? But truthfully, they should run on the same ticket. We don't need any more Bushes or Clintons. Let somebody else have a turn. In the hell are the churches? You know, I heard that the best parking places in hell have signs that say reserved for clergy. But check this out. A Florida Christian group that feeds the poor, and they've been doing this for over 30 years, was told by the Department of Agriculture they can no longer receive USDA food unless they remove portraits of Christ, take down the Ten Commandments, take down a banner that reads Jesus is Lord, and stop giving Bibles to the needy. Basically, stop that Christian business. Where are our churches? Our churches pretend this stuff isn't happening. But anyway, I want to salute Kay Daly, the charity's director. She told these government freaks in no uncertain terms that they could kiss her Bible. Stories like this are just more examples of stories ignored by the criminal mainstream broadcast news media, ABC, CBS, CNN, and NBC, and their affiliates. I'm telling you, if these guys are not the head of the snake, they are damn sure holding the microphone for them. These are the guys that have spouses and siblings in the White House. And for you liberals watching, you don't find it a tad odd they never question our government? You know, I believe there's a special place in hell for these network news folks that continue to betray the trust of Americans who've welcomed them into their living rooms for decades.
Turn their asses off.
Less conversation, a little more action. All this
so lucky. People, we don't realize how lucky we are. But we live in a time where federal politicians never go to jail. They're such angels. But apparently, they're not regular angels. They're magical angels. And I'm going to show you. According to the Congressional Budget Office, our federal deficit spending increased in August by $146 billion. But magically, the debt didn't move. It remained exactly at $16,699,396,000,000, which in an amazing coincidence is $25 million under the maximum legal limit.
Ho, 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 it's magic.
But you know what? Forget the deficit spending for August. In fact, forget July and June too. This debt number has not changed one red cent since May. That's over 100 days. But it must not be important because our media is not covering it. It's certainly not up there with Miley Cyrus. Or Smiley Cyrus or Cy Bentley. But now, I ain't no Charles Cotton Schwab, but how does spending money that you don't have not increase your debt? With magic. See? It's those magical angels. I'm telling you.
Ho, 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 it's magic.
No, they're not magical angels. They're despicable politicians who are no different than used car salesmen who used to roll back the odometers. It's a con to hide the real numbers.
The best things in life are free, but you can give them to the birds and bees. I want money. That's what I want. Thrill. But your love won't pay my bills. I want money. That's what I want. That's what I want. That's what I want.
You know, but most of the folks that talk about debt and deficit, they don't even know what the hell they're talking about. It's not the same thing. Debt is a fixed amount set by law by Congress. Well, allegedly it's law. and it's against the law for our government to exceed this amount. That's that amount that has remained $25 million under the legal limit since May. Now, deficit. Now, that's the amount of money that you are spending above the amount of money that you're taking in. Now, here's a cool demonstration of our deficit, starting in 2007 when the Democrats took over. And this guy uses shots of Jack Daniels to help his demonstration. And he simply goes by the name Political Math. And this video's a little old, so the numbers are even worse now. But I think you're going to enjoy this.
Let's say that one shot of sour mash is $100 billion. The year Harry Reid and the Democrats took control of Congress, the deficit was 1.5 shots. The following year, the deficit jumped to 4.5 shots. Suddenly, we had gone from a manageable amount of deficit to the largest one in U.S. history. Fortunately for us, Obama, the candidate, promised to rein in spending and reduce this massive deficit. Unfortunately for us, the following year, tax revenue collapsed, the stimulus passed, and we're looking at downing 14 hard shots of deficit in a single year. This wasn't just a world record. It blew the previous record away by so much that we can only look back at 4.5 shots of deficit as a fond memory to which we may someday return, like a discarded kitten who scratched up our couch but was infinitely preferable to the starving hyena we selected to replace it. At 15 shots, or $1.5 trillion, this year is looking a little bit worse than the last one.
Now, Intellectual Froglegs does not condone or encourage drinking and calculating.
And so it's almost surprising that that number says 44% say don't raise the debt ceiling, because the president's argument is always that the government has already extended those dollars, they have already put out that money, and it's just about paying the bills.
We want to welcome my friend, town hall columnist, and owner of Right Wing News, the infamous John Hawkins, to the show. Hawkins. Welcome.
It is great to be with you, Joe Dan. I don't think they allow two southern white boys to talk politics anymore. I think we may be breaking 7 or 8 FEC regulations just by having this conversation.
we must and we will much about that be committed.
You just had an article recently, the top five corporations that should be blacklisted by conservatives. How about sharing those with us? Number five. Boom.
Number five, the AARP. These guys are the ones who are stopping any type of entitlement reform from coming through. They are fighting for, believe it or not, Planned Parenthood. Why in the world is the old folks group fighting for Planned Parenthood? They fought for Obamacare. You might as well give your money directly to the Democratic Party as give it to the AARP. Do not be a member of those guys. There's conservative groups out there. Join those. Do anything other than the AARP.
Okay, number four.
Number four, Starbucks. Not only are these guys pro-gay marriage, but they actually had a shareholder stand up in a meeting and say, listen, we're having boycotts. This has cost us money. And he's like, if you don't like it, get out. So that's the message he sent it to everybody. If you're a Christian, you don't like gay marriage, get out. Starbucks doesn't want your business. Don't give it to them. You can get your overpriced coffee somewhere else.
You know, it blows my mind the number of conservatives out here talking about, well, I got to go to Starbucks and I'll be back. But... Number three,
Capital One. The only thing you need to know about these guys is they got Alec Baldwin as their spokesman. He's about to get a show on MSNBC. This is a guy who's gone out there and ripped, you know, he supported Obama for president. He rips on the Tea Party. Why do you want to go out and spend your money with a corporation that's hiring a guy who hates people like you? I mean, what message does that send? That message they're sending to you is screw you. So why are you giving them your money?
And wasn't he like one of the faces of Occupy Wall Street?
Yeah, this guy's done all this stuff, man. Anything that's left wing, he's there. He's shooting off his mouth. Anything you can do to get rid of this guy is better. So why give your money to a corporation that pays a guy like that to just be in your face? Hey, we don't want your business. That's what they're saying about hiring as a spokesman.
Absolutely. Number dos.
Progressive Insurance. You can tell Flo to shove it. Because Peter Lewis, the guy that runs that, he's one of the biggest left-wing sugar daddies there are. He's just almost as big as Soros. You just don't hear his name as often. So that guy's taking your insurance money, pocketing it, and then giving it to the Democrat Party. Get your insurance somewhere else.
Drum roll, please. The number one corporation that conservatives should blacklist is...
Chrysler. Not only do they get bailed out, there's a lot of corporations that got bailed out, and that's bad enough, but now the unions, because of the bailout, own 55% of the corporation. So this isn't a corporation that has union employees. This is a union with a corporation attached to it. You would be better off just giving your money to Michael Moore than you would be giving it to the United Auto Workers, and those are the guys that run Chrysler.
We are the 99%! Yes!
Don't buy any cars from Chrysler. There's a lot of car companies, ones that are not going to go out and try to cream you. And everything you believe in, these guys are fighting against. And every time you buy a car from Chrysler, you're paying these guys to try to undercut what you believe in.
Didn't they move some of their operations to Italy or something? Did I see that? Or?
Yes, that's why we've got those terrible Fiat commercials on where they've got the horrible little cars and the dancing women who are talking about a revolution. You look like a car that looks like a golf cart. That's why we got that going on.
You know, those little tiny cars, man, the best way in the world to piss somebody off. Here in Kansas City, you know, we've got this area called the Plaza. I mean, and it is, oh man, you can even smell the liberalism if you're downwind. But they drive those little tiny cars, you know, and I walk by one, I said, what is that? what is that thing? Well, that's my car. I said, no, seriously.
You can smell the liberalism. What's it smell like? I'm guessing rancid bacon.
Hey, dog.
I hate to even put bacon in that category.
Well, I did say rancid bacon. You rancid. Know, it's like it's bacon. It should smell good, but it's what is going on with the bacon, you know?
But I swear, one of the funniest things, I was there at the Plaza. And they had a Hare Krishna rock band. And they didn't know any Hank Jr., though. They seemed to be offended that I asked.
Did they give you any flowers or ask for any donations when you went up and asked for Hank Williams?
Oh, they were startled and then frightened.
That sounds about right.
But anyway, we can sit and chat for a long time, man. I appreciate you coming on.
Well, make sure to cut this thing down and make me sound brilliant. Just take like one word out of each 10 sentences, and then we'll have it down to one sentence while I sound incredible on there.
You figured out my secret. And make sure you guys follow John Hawkins. Go to, you can find him at where? Right Wing News? Where else?
RightWingNews.com, Linkiest.com, TheLookingSpoon.com. I also write for Town Hall. I got Facebook page, the official Right Wing News Facebook page. Make sure to join that. Hit me on Twitter, John Hawkins, RWN. If it's somewhere in media and the conservatives there, I'm probably there, so look for me.
Thanks again. Take care, my friend. Democrats have been drooling to go to war. Now, for you liberal hypocrites watching, and I know some of you guys do, I get your notes. Where are your war protesters?
Yeah.
What is it good for?
Absolutely
nothing.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
What is it good for?
Absolutely
nothing.
Say it again, y'all.
I pledge
to be a servant to our president.
All mankind, because together we can, together we are.
You know, despite our being dropped and banned and censured and purged from proper society, as defined by those that wave the conservative flag as long as it's profitable, you know what? We're separating the carpetbaggers from the patriots. And now we've got some heroes and patriots starting to step up, and we want to salute them. So I'm proud to announce the first member of the Frogleg Rhino Hunters Club, I'm41.com. Go visit them, go support them, go sign up with them. Because I'm telling you, conservatives ignoring the media elephant in the room, that's like, well, aside from that, Ms. Lincoln, how did you like the play? It's time for Heroes and Patriots.
Speak out, and speak out loudly and passionately. Not in hushed tones, no whispering. You love this country, damn it, then say so. And I don't mean just say I love it. Speak out.
And for you bloggers out there that call yourself conservative journalists, you know what? If you can't write a story about the radical left without providing a revenue-generating link to the radical left, you don't need to be writing because you're not a writer. We've had journalists writing successfully and poignantly in newspapers and periodicals for centuries, and yet they didn't have links. But they didn't even have computers. So you can go sell that excuse to somebody else.
It amazes me that people don't love Obama.
Proud to welcome my friend. What's your name again?
I need some rest.
Please stop by the website, antlersandfroglegs.com. And with all this banning and crap going on, you should probably subscribe to my email alerts. There's also links to hook up with me on Facebook and Twitter. And God bless you guys for the awesome and very necessary donations. And by the way, I'm smack in the middle of two root canals. Hint, hint. But listen, Froglegs are free to watch, but they ain't free to make. So thanks for the donations. Anyway, please share the show with your friends and share with some Democrat voters. We need the numbers. And keep up those misspelled insults, you liberal bichachos.
Scorpion, you might have got us both killed.